Sunfall here for hit and run. This is on hard difficulty, and now that we got that pesky achievement out of the way on easy difficulty, we don't have to worry about being downed or having our bot downed, which will make this much easier. So again, you want to look at the floor. I wanted to test if you could do it from the front rather than the back, and it does work.
Here we go! Contact!
Do your best for evade shots. Use the desk.
I've been hit! Help me out!
See, within 5 minutes, my bot went down.
I need help!
So this is the whole reason why we did the other one on easy. It was just us. Because my bot's in the way of bullets, and on this difficulty can go down very quickly. I can too, don't get me wrong, but I'm more likely not to, because I avoid that as best as I can. Be cautious when coming out.
Watch that door.
Try and quickly place the claymore and then run back into the previous room. This will give you cover if the claymore doesn't go off, which for some reason sometimes it doesn't seem to. Stick at the back because if they come through the door like they're doing, you got some cover for more than just one thing. Make sure not to go near the window. That's why I'm sticking to the back here. Because the guys on the scaffold at this difficulty are a lot more brutal. Just healing my health before I pop back out. Now I can start dealing with the scaffold. That's all the scaffolding people, it looks like, so we're clear to continue. Remember, here we'll have 3 people, sometimes just 2. Instead of going in like last time, you stick to the door like I was doing so you can go for cover if you need it. Now I can pick up some much needed ammo. So again, we want to stick to our strategy and go with the stairs here. And stick to the left wall. And then we'll be ducking and cover a lot more than we were. you want to really try to get this guy first. The guy upstairs and this guy here, he's your main target. Guys right behind there. If you run out of ammo, you can easily run back and get some more. So if you remember this part from the easy run through, well now we're doing it on hard, so it'll be a little bit different and a little bit more difficult. Oh, and also wanted to show you something interesting that I'll be doing. So this door here, and it, how it wants you to interact with it, you don't actually have to. But for now, let me go get my bot. And we park him under this wall here. See, it says open door. We don't need to open the door. If you run out this way, it'll activate them.
Cover the window!
I know I probably should have showed you that on easy rather than hard, but you know, whatevs. So you want to pretty much kneel for this part. And at most points, you want to crouch too, it's just easier. You want to stick to the edge of this building. I'm gonna pretty much shoot through this little gap, leaning out occasionally. There's one guy that I just couldn't hit. It'd probably be better if I had a thought about throwing a grenade, but I didn't. And see where my bot is, he's safe. So I can just turn him around and heal, which I'll do in a sec. I just wanted to try and get a few shots off with the pistol. Again, you just want to keep popping out and slowly taking them out as you see them. Getting ammo when it's needed. See, the grenades they're throwing are actually getting themselves as well. Much slower flight than it was on easy because you can't take as many risks, but this is still the easiest way I found to do it. Guy for some reason decided he was going to charge us. Didn't work out for him. So now we'll have this guy bust through the door again. Man, I'll get my bot ready to go downstairs. I liked my positioning I had, did on easy, so I stuck with it. As you can see, I'm just moving him downstairs. Straight away fire and get the guy that runs at you. And move my bot out of danger while I was still on me, that's why he was walking a little bit funny. Because I was using my view to move him, but you want to get the guys upstairs. Get to the ammo, but while I was busy dealing with that, these guys decided to come in.
Come on, I need help.
The top guys are dealt with, we can head back downstairs and start taking these guys out. Since they thought they were all tough taking out someone that's not firing back, let's see how they fare against someone who is firing back. On this difficulty, I do recommend being up here more than downstairs, because you've got more of an angle to shoot them. They also have more of an angle to shoot you up there, but it's still better for you. I'm trying to make sure I take out as many before I head to the ammo, but at the same time I know I'm running out of ammo. Remember to get the ones in the window. I don't have much ammo, so I'll be resorting to the pistol in a minute. Pistol has a pretty decent accuracy, you just gotta fire numerous times. Now I can finally head to the ammo box that I've been desperate for. Make sure to keep leaning and leaning back out for cover and reloading. You don't want to be exposed while you're reloading. I'm like fish in a barrel. I just came pouring in that cubicle. Okay, should be able to jump down now. Remember, there'll be more enemies to spawn once we get into this area. So again, try and stay back, hang back so you can get cover if you need to. Like, as you can see right here, I'm in cover. Because I got pelted pretty good. Again, stick to the left, because I feel like the left is better when you pop out here. Remember to keep an eye on those poles. Collect the ammo and then we can go up this way. There'll be two guys to pop out if you remember. One on the right and one on the left. Stick to the cover here so that way we can take them out. So for this part we're gonna have to stay in cover as well, so I recommend the red pole, because we'll be able to see them through there. Take out as many as you can in this hallway, if any. In my case, none. Keep an eye on your ammo reserves, because otherwise you can go back and grab more. There's a guy in that doorway there. He's always hiding there. Once the music subsides, we should be good to go. Now at the garage again, there'll be 5 enemies, mostly with shotguns. A couple of them have assault rifles, but mostly shotguns. Stick to the doorway. They'll try and charge you. And you just have to deal with them as they come through the door. I only counted about 4 then, so I know there's a 5th one still alive. And then he gives up his position by shouting. I still don't think that's everybody. Better to play it cautious when you're on this level, so I'm using the angle so I can try and see if there's any more. And I was right, there was one more hiding. So it was good I played it cautious. With that, that's everybody, so we can race to the door. And then once we get to the door, we bring the pod in, kill the 2 guys, and we take the car right out of here. So again, we've got the bot moving part, so give me a minute to fast forward so that the bot can catch up to us. Now we can get in the car and then we can finish this mission. Thank you for watching, I hope this was helpful. La confusion à Montréal, pas de mal sur les liens.